Hello. Now, this is the time of year that I think about all the books that I'm going to give for Christmas. I always give books. And this year, I've already gotten some books as gifts from my family who pass on books they think I would be very interested in. So, I'm holding up this book to see which one of my family wants it for Christmas. Shay. The story of Shay Guevara, who was the famous revolutionary in Cuba. And this book is 700 pages long. It was written in 1997. And I can't imagine a biography being any more thorough than this one, because I remember so well all the tension, all the concern I had at the time about what was going to happen in Cuba. So reading this book was really a very good experience, because now I feel, on top of the concern that I had then, I understand what was happening much better. And when you understand something, you don't fear it as much, because if the author, the writer, the biographer is good, he can help you to understand why this person acted the way he did. And he, of course, influenced Fidel Castro a great deal. And I'd say that he was mostly responsible for him embracing communism and eventually telling people he was a communist. He had studied Lenin and Mao, all of the communist leaders who'd written about their beliefs and what constituted communism. And I've always become acquainted with communism or a leftist swing in our country, then this could be called an understanding of what communists were trying to achieve. And newspapers in our country, a number of them, took the swing to the left. And this culminated in the legalizing of abortion, which had been legalized in communist countries, China, Russia. And in reading this book, I could see a lot more why the violence of that solution didn't really deter the communists, because of the beliefs that communism could not be a communistic country, a true country for the people, could not come about without guerrilla warfare, without fighting. In fact, Che was criticized during his lifetime, he and Fidel both, because of the firing squads that they issued, the firing squads that they always had to punish people severely, who, they regarded as traitors. And of course, people were changing their mind all the time. They were signing up, and then they were changing their mind and leaving the next day. And But if there was an especially one that very disturbed them, they'd likely shoot that person. And later on, he was asked how many times by his friends, his family, Shay was asked why he had changed so much in regard to capital punishment, that is, immediate death as punishment. And this was in combat when they were trying to take over Cuba. This started these severe punishments for what they would regard as treachery, something that deserved the death sentence right then. And I found that to be the most disturbing, and it was undoubtedly the reason why this movement was criticized so heavily, just because of the brutality of these executions. Right when they were, you know, trying to take over Cuba, they would have executions of people that they thought were traitors or and so on. So this book, you know, caused me to think again about my own beliefs, and I have been disturbed because I came out of a religion which influenced me. I'm from Utah, came out of Mormonism, and Mormons are very much against abortion, and this was their abortion numbers are low. So I was influenced by the fact that they found a way not to be as brutal as legalized abortion is. And they made it work. Because it was like from the beginning of life, it was held sacred. You did not, just like marriage was held sacred. That's another feature of the Mormon religion, is marriage in a temple for time and all eternity. Well, I happen to have been born to skeptics, a free-thinking father and grandfather on the one side, and was introduced to the ideas of, was this really, for example, polygamy. This was another big question and doubt that caused a lot of people to reject Mormonism based on the early years of polygamy and the fact that it was still in their lexicon of belief, even though it had been outlawed, banned, not by them, but by the President of the United States. So we come right up against the fact that when the people have to change a law, and believe it or not, polygamy was the fastest way that Brigham Young could fill up the state of Utah with Mormons. And I am sure that was not lost on him, because in order for the Mormons to defend themselves, for them to grow, for them to become powerful in their own state, they had to have a lot of them. And polygamy, like I just got to reading another book about the Comanches, saying that Quanah Parker, for example, the great Comanche Indian chief whose mother was white, he had, there were Comanches who lived in polygamy, and there was a practical reason, so that they, wives could do all the work that a Comanche, the tribe that was the greatest horse tribe That is, they used horses to great effect. And there was a lot of work involved in moving all the time, which the horses helped them to do. So there's always practical reasons for very disturbing habits or ways of life that spring up in a people. And I think reading an objective account of some of these practices help you to understand why those people developed a kind of disturbing policy that the Cubans did. So I was very curious about how they justified this. And I haven't finished the book. I've still got a little bit left. But I have found it one of the best I could possibly imagine to educate you on what happened in Cuba to when Batista was overthrown and that country was, well, turned into a communistic country. And then I'm reading what effect this had on the rest of the South American countries. Because it's always good to educate yourself about the place you live, or even the earth. The more you can understand it, the better. And for me, one way of understanding is to find the best books written about something and read it. And this is a practice I have kept, I have done all my life. I'm a fast reader by now, and so I have a sister who just reads a book like and that comes from a lot of reading. And I've always given books to my kids. I've taken them to the library when they were 3 years old to get them sold on the idea that books, they needed books, that would become part of their lives. So anyway, kids, give me a message. Whoever wants this book the most, whoever's dying to read a 700-page tome, well, that's nothing. They'll be able to read. I have some kids that are very fast readers, too. They can devour a book like this a lot faster than you might imagine. But that comes with practice. So let me know.